The quality of sperm is not just the number and speed at which they swim. It boils down to what they're actually doing, and that is delivering the DNA of the man into the egg. So I think it's important to realise that smoking is not so much affecting number and speed, but affecting the quality of the product. Smoking damages sperm from the very beginning of their development. Now, it takes about 2 months for a sperm to go from a stem cell into the little tadpole-shaped thing that we all recognise. And that process involves the duplication of DNA and its compaction into a very tight little head. Now, that whole process is quite vulnerable to damage, particularly from cigarette smoke. So it's not a question of the sperm on the day of ejaculation, it's the process that started 2 months earlier. So if a man wants to protect the quality of his sperm, he has to start months before he actually causes the conception. The good thing about smoking and sperm damage is it's reversible. If you stop smoking, those chemicals that damage the sperm's DNA during production will disappear, and the next batch of sperm will be fine. So it is something that it doesn't matter how long you've smoked for, if you stop now, within just a few months, the benefits in terms of quality sperm production will be evident. I always ask about smoking in evaluating the infertile couple or the infertile man. And if he says he's a smoker, I say from the very outset, that's something you do want to think about stopping. Stopping because it'll damage your sperm and the quality of the DNA that will start your baby. And there are health consequences to that, to the offspring. There is epidemiological evidence that the offspring of men who smoked during conception or around the time of conception are damaged. And so, for example, high rates of cancer. We were always aware of the need for the mother not to drink, not to smoke, etc. But I think we now realise it's a couple's responsibility. If you're going to start a baby, you both have responsibilities to start with healthy sperm and healthy eggs. So I think it's important that men understand that at that very first discussion. If you want to be running around the park and playing footy with your 10 or 20 year old kids, you have to look after your health from there. So, I mean, parenthood is a big responsibility, and there's certain things we can control and some things we can't control. And you'd like to think that smoking is something that we have the ability to understand and to stop. But it's so important to start your fatherhood on the right foot, and that starts with the healthiest possible sperm you can make.